going the wrong way.
Just ran it over.
What?
It's in pieces, dude.
Why did I bother to check that? I just saw the propeller spinning. I was like, that's good enough.
Was it reversed?
It was reversed.
Everybody hurts sometimes.
What's the alien?
Hey guys, look, no hands boating.
Oh!
Essentially, what you're saying is that you're putting me in the worst noob environment possible
to fly a semi-noob capable airplane.
Okay, Stefan. So I'm assuming you've never flown a seaplane before, right?
This is true.
So basically what I have the FT Otter right here, and this is a fairly simple single engine build. I designed it to be for the intermediate to advanced and even beginner pilot if you guys are somewhat proficient. So I'm going to help train Stefan to fly off the water for the first time with this thing. So let's get into it.
Let's go. Where do you want me to lay it? Right near Peter?
There it goes. I'm going to put it in the water.
Put it in the water?
Face it towards that way.
That way?
Yeah, because the wind's coming out of that way.
Here goes nothing.
Oh.
It's up. What are you doing right now, Peter?
All right now I'm getting the Otter trimmed out for you, because this one hasn't really been trimmed out yet, okay. So I'm just taking
hasn't
it up
really
for a quick spin. Yep.
So you're giving me a cold machine.
I'm giving you a cold machine.
I appreciate that.
Plop. All right, so it seems pretty stable. Everything seems pretty good.
Oh, dang. So now how does the wind affect you here on the lake, Peter?
The wind actually affects us a lot. If you guys notice, as soon as you get out of the water, the wind starts picking up and grabbing the airplane and swinging around.
Right.
So just be in mind of that too, because at the surface level of the lake, it's actually really calm. But as soon as you start getting rolling, it's up in the air.
Okay, fair enough.
All right, I'm going to bring this thing around and land it, and I'm going to hand it off to you.
Oh, great. Woo! Beauty. Oh, that was a nice landing.
All right, grab the airplane. Let me see this. The plane was just a little bit tail heavy, so I'm moving the battery just forward just a little bit more.
Okay.
Just to get the CG just right for you.
CG.
Okay.
Center of gravity. So if you haven't seen so far, the water now is beating on top of this new water-resistant foam board, which is phenomenal.
Yep.
Because it's not gonna sink into your lake. You want to put it in the water again?
Yep. I'll put it in the water.
Okay.
You take your hands and sticks.
Okay.
Now I'm gonna brief you a little bit on this too.
All right, cool.
So in the water, if you do see the tip of the float sinking in the water, because it is not super buoyant, just go ahead and stop the controls, let the plane kind of center itself out, and as soon as this top part of the wing comes up above the water, and you see this underwater, add a little bit of power, because as soon as this moves forward, it'll shoot up out of the water, because how much it's angled. All right?
Tap in the power, huh?
Yep.
All right.
And now for takeoff, here's the thing too, because everything happens really, really fast in this airplane. You're going to add power. And as soon as the plane hips and skips a little bit, gently pull up and just get away from the water.
Just gently up and down?
Yep. And you should be in and out of the water this time.
Oh my goodness gracious.
Okay, here it is.
They couldn't just do this on land.
You're in the water, bro. You're in the water.
All right, taxi forward. Add a little power. There you go. Add a little bit more. Turn the rudder towards to the wind. There you go. Add more power. A little more power. There you go. Now keep it going. You're good. All right. A little more power. Now steer that way. You got to steer with your rudder. You're steering the wrong way. Oh. All right, give us some power, Austin.
Dude, this is ridiculous.
You steer the wrong way. The rudder's moving. You got to use a lot of rudder when you're in the water, too.
Well, let's see what we got here.
Okay, so you did up in the drink, but the reason why is because you didn't use enough rudder, because water planes too are something that's kind of heavy. Yeah. To steer in the water, it's like a jet ski. Like, you need power to turn the airplane around in the water.
Okay.
So if the plane's drifting one way, you have to add a shot of power and add some rudder command to kind of get the plane to go where it needs to go.
Okay.
Yay for Corrosion X.
Hey, Alex.
So the plane did end up upside down, but luckily this is a freshwater thing of water, lake, I guess, that's what we call it. So the plane actually didn't have any waterproofing, but if you guys are gonna fly off of saltwater or saltwater mixes, I highly recommend flying or checking out our Corrosion X episode where we show you how to waterproof an airplane, because it basically shows you tips and tricks on how to make these survive water. So I brought, luckily, a can of it with me. It's in this dirty bag. I sprayed it all over the airplane, so we're good to go now. All right, Stephen, so you ready to try it again? All right, in the water you go. All right, add some power. That's cool. A little bit more power. Steer at the rudder. There you go. Add more power. There you go. Keep going, more power. Pull back a little bit, and you're airborne.
Nice.
Oh!
There you go.
Oh, dude, what
is that? It's gusty, so that's what you're hearing. It's just hitting you. You can pull the power a little bit. Just stay at around half throttle to 75% throttle, and there you go.
Dude, oh my gosh. It's pretty plain now.
The reason it's falling that too, because you're hitting a lot of bumpy air up there.
Yeah.
Right now it's calm right here, but up there you're getting slammed around.
I feel it.
All right, cool. While you're up, I'm gonna run up there and just meet you up there in this airplane.
All right, man.
You're killing it right now, dude.
It's all about the pattern.
Here, do a nice long smooth takeoff.
Okay.
This is awesome! There's quite a bit of wind up there, right?
Yep. Just click for turn.
Wanna try flying a little bit lower? Wanna buzz the boat?
Buzz the
boat. Come on, buzz the boat.
Look at my plane, it's like...
It's getting slammed around, so is mine, yeah. I'm gonna come past the boat, so I'll do it.
Okay. Watch the
phantom. Okay. Yeah, let's start you off on the seaplane first time.
Now do some passes.
Now just do some low passes near the boat, but Stop, try to keep your thing it. Airborne.
He's actually a pretty good pilot, too.
Just don't ask me to turn right.
That's okay, just keep doing what you're doing. I'll admit, this is a very, very bad day to do this. For a new pilot to fly off of water and fly a seaplane, you're doing amazing.
Hey, thanks, Peter. That's the first nice thing you've ever said to me.
Hey, I enjoy your donuts you bring in every Monday,
hey,
or every day.
Anytime, brother. For Josh's sake, he's not here today, so I'm gonna be the brother friend guy.
Well, before anything happens, do you want to try landing?
Oh. I'm gonna try a close pass towards the boat, and we're gonna see what happens.
All right.
About how much throttle would you do on this pass?
Pull the power up to about, try half throttle.
Here we go.
All right, here we go. We're gonna come buzzing down the deck. Here comes the pass.
I wasn't super close, but hey.
All right, cool. Do you want to try another one or do you want to try landing?
Let's try one more time.
All right, cool. I'm going to formation up with you.
All right, bro. Bring myself back here. Sometimes when you get a hit with a wind gust, you know what I mean?
Yeah, because that was involuntary, that up and down thing
exactly.
I just did. Because I'm getting hit really hard.
I'm getting hit smashed, so I might be in the drink here.
Yeah.
It's okay.
All right.
It's only foam board. We got more of it.
Woo! Oh, he turned right.
Not happening, bro.
All right, do you want to land?
Yeah, but I'm coming in.
Turn towards us. Turn towards us, and slowly pull the power out. There you go. Pull the power out. Pull all the way out.
All right, I will come back around.
Okay.
Come back around again when you were gone.
All right, I'm watching you, Stefan.
All right, buddy, coming in hot here. You're gonna come back around.
All right, come around a little more, pull up. Oh, watch out for the trees. Watch out for that tree. Oh, it's in the tree. Oh, it's in the tree.
Oh my gosh, we're in the tree, bro.
Yeah, I played stuck in a tree for a while.
Dude.
Well, that was awesome. So, it is a little bit windy for a first-time pilot, so what you got there is you got pretty much just forced right into that tree at high speed.
Yeah.
Because this is a calm evening airplane.
Oh,
my plane's upside down too. It just got blown upside down too. So I guess it's a wrap here, because my plane's upside down. Your plane's in a tree. So I guess some quick tips: buy this airplane because it's awesome, but fly it on a calm evening or be a pro pilot.
Do not run into trees.
Yep.
Well, that didn't end that great.
Nah, that didn't go too well.
So, what was your experiences?
Well, at the end of the day, at least mine didn't get run over by a boat.
Yeah, but I think you just ended up in a tree.
That's true.
But yeah, a lot had to do with the combination of the winds that day. It was really choppy too on water, so that was your first flip over too.
Right.
If you notice, the plane got dug in the water, and then the wind came and grabbed and swung right over. So basically, that touches on this plane is really a fair weather airplane. It's meant for calm evenings on a smooth lake or pond, because it's a light system too. It's a power pack B, which is on your airplane.
Right.
Power pack C on mine, but a slowly propped one. And usually lighter setup too. So those light airplanes don't work very well on calm seas, as you noticed.
Right, no, it was very windy. Mine flipped over twice the whole day, so.
But still, dude, you did amazing for that.
I appreciate it.
For a first time pilot being nervous too on water, because airplanes, electronics, and water don't generally mix, you did amazing.
I
still would love to see a landing, but yeah, you got slammed by wind gusts and planted firmly in that tree. I think that thing still might be there.
Yeah, probably still there.
Watch out for that tree. Oh, it's in the tree. Oh, it's in the tree.
Well, since I ran over my really, really pretty one, I built this other one.
Hey, it looks just as good as the other one.
Yeah, and you know, the one thing though, since that happened, what happened was the propeller was turning the wrong direction. And you chucked that thing as hard as you could chuck it right off the bow of that boat while we were moving at like a good 10 miles an hour, and it was all over.
I did. I chucked as hard as I could, and it just...
Check your propeller rotation if you're ever gonna hand launch something off a moving vehicle. You wanna make sure your propeller is gonna push you forward rather than pull you backwards so you go under the boat, get ran over, and just get this really distressed look on your face.
True.
Your plane floats out from the bottom, all bottomed up and down the surface.
In 17 different pieces.
Yeah, that was no good.
Dunzo.
I was so sad. So sad.
It was okay though, we all had a good laugh about it.
Today's not my day.
Bro, dude, I chuck it and it's just like, bam, bam, wow.
As bad as it turned out, I think it was still kind of fun. It was still pretty good.
It was a blast. We had a good time with it, and I can't wait to test it out again, to be honest with you.
And honestly, that really shows the limits of this design. Normally, we don't do that too much, but this really shows you the very limitations of when you should never, ever fly off the water.
Right.
Basically, in days like that, when the waves are just doing this, and the wind's blowing, and you're kind of a new pilot with the water, it's not a very good experience, so hopefully we cracked up some airplanes on our own, so you guys don't have to. If you're new to float planes too, be sure to check out some of our other videos, such as like the Tidewater episode, the how to waterproof your airplanes, and even how to float fly for the first time. We've even had a guy named Alan Bruce. He actually lives on a lake down in South Carolina, and we've actually crashed down there, and he's had some huge gas airplanes, and he's had tons of experiences flying off water. So real cool stuff.
Sounds
check that
like
out.
You gotta go to.
Yeah, and I guess I'm gonna get out of here too, because I really want to try this on some calmer water.
Let's go get it done, huh?
Right, yep.
Thank you.
most of all today. We had some accidents. The plane got ran over by the boat. Things could have been better, but they weren't. And this is supposed to be nice.